Is the universe expanding, or are we shrinking away from it? Dark energy explained in 6 minutes and why it doesn't exist. My name is Demian, and this is Growing Together. The universe expands and accelerates at a rate of 72 kilometers per second per megaparsec, in addition to their own relative movement through space. 72 kilometers per second is insignificant and negligible for things that are close, because this speed is very slow when considering how fast objects move in space. At a distance of 2 megaparsecs away, objects recede from us at 144 kilometers per second. But this velocity is still insignificant. However, at 4,164 megaparsecs away, everything is receding away from us and each other at the speed of light due to this expansion rate. This is caused by space itself expanding and accelerating, and not the motion of matter in space. So it doesn't mean that matter is traveling at the speed of light, because it can't. Only space itself can expand faster than light at those distances. That's what they say. The cause of this accelerated expansion is unknown, and we call it dark energy, not to be confused with dark matter. Gravity suggests everything should be slowing down, but 97% of the universe is moving away from us faster than the speed of light due to this mysterious expansion. The cosmological constant is the main theory for dark energy today, proposing a constant energy density in empty space, acting as a repulsive force. Quintessence and modified gravity are other proposed theories, which claim a scalar field exists, similar to the Higgs field, or extra dimensions as the cause for expansion. None of those theories have any direct evidence for the proposed causes of expansion, and some, like extra dimensions, can't even be experimentally tested. Faith is defined as a belief or trust in something without requiring evidence or proof. Under this definition, the causes proposed for dark energy are statements of faith, and I feel that science is not being honest about that. So what causes dark energy? Can we explain it using testable and observable phenomena instead of relying on unproven concepts? Let's try. Black holes cause gravitational lensing, but this effect would look different if we are in close proximity to a black hole and accelerating towards one. Because of proximity, what we observe with dark energy is the gravitational lensing magnification effect on us as observers. Theoretical mathematics proves this with Einstein, black holes, and known forces of nature. If the solar system is heading towards periapsis around a black hole partner, or it encountered a rogue black hole, dark energy would be explained by the sun's proximity to it and its acceleration towards it. We are in the gravitational funnel of a local black hole. Observing normal gravitational lensing requires us to be outside of the funnel. In the funnel, we spiral inward, causing the rest of the universe to spiral outward, creating the observational effect of dark energy. The Matthew hypothesis explains dark energy without the need for adding elements of faith in science, and it also explains what we observe for dark matter as well. Here are 8 predictions that must occur if the hypothesis is correct. I'm putting the Matthew hypothesis under the fire and scrutiny of the scientific method. One last thing I want to mention regarding dark energy and the age of our universe. We use the Hubble constant to rewind the clock back to determine the age of our universe. If this orbit is true, the age of the universe is undeterminable. That's because as we head towards periapsis, the age of the universe will get older and older. And as we head away from periapsis, the age of the universe will get younger and younger and begin to contract. Time is relative. There are things in nature that saw the entire universe be born and die in an instant, as well as things in nature that experience the beginning and end of the universe in trillions and trillions and trillions of years. What I am saying is not science fiction. It is basic general relativity. We have to stop thinking that the age of our universe has years. Seeing the universe in this way is erroneous and goes against everything that we understand in science today. Time is relative. The universe is not only expanding and accelerating away from us, we are also slowing down in time as the gravitational field and velocity and acceleration of us as observers gets closer and closer to this black hole partner of the sun. Earlier, I mentioned faith because I am actually a person of deep faith. I named it the Matthew Hypothesis based on my faith after reading Matthew 24:29 when I was studying black holes 18 years ago. What Christ said in that verse is literal if the sun falls into a black hole. But my faith in Christ does not invalidate the science. Because of faith, I'm able to look at this hypothesis without feeling terror or despair. On the contrary, I felt inspired and in awe as discoveries confirmed this hypothesis over the past 18 years, and nobody realizes that everything is upside down when it comes to dark energy and dark matter. And it only confirms that everything else Christ said is also true for me as a person of faith. But I separate faith from science, and I am honest about it in everything I propose. Be good to yourselves and each other. Let me know what you think in the comments. Like, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.